Coming to you exclusively on Mojave County Craigslist Rants and Raves, and broadcasting live from a secret location along the Colorado River, it is The Ripper.
Hello and welcome. I am The River. It is the 4th of July. Whee! You know, this is the very first video, River video show, and I'm just so happy that you could be here with me. You know, this is a great day, the 4th of July. What a day to speak out for freedom and to do everything that you can, that thing an American entitles you to do. What a wonderful day. But you know, I am really perplexed. And I don't know why this is happening, but it seems to be. Why is it we're trying to take God out of everything that we do? Here on Father's Day, this last month, during the U.S. Open in Washington, D.C., NBC opened it with dramatic music and patriotic pictures of soldiers carrying the flag to raise it up. And then they cut to a bunch of children saying the Pledge of Allegiance. Except that it did something really strange. Now, when they were saying the Pledge of Allegiance, they stopped and they cut to patriotic images from around Washington, D.C., and then they come back, and something's missing. A couple of words, three words. Under God and indivisible. They not only did it once, they did it twice. Two times NBC cut out under God and indivisible. Well, they issued an apology saying, well, we really didn't mean to offend anybody, and it was just an honest mistake. No, it wasn't. One time is an honest mistake. Twice in the same segment, you did it on purpose. And don't tell me it was the same time. It wasn't. You did it purposely. Whether you did it to offend people is a different story. I don't believe you did it to actually offend people. I think you did it because you don't like America. You don't like the fact that we are one nation under God. And we are indivisible. Abraham Lincoln said, a house divided against itself cannot stand. We learned that during the Civil War. We learned that we have to be one group of Americans. That was one of the reasons behind the Pledge of Allegiance. You know, NBC, here's a quick little lesson for you. The Pledge of Allegiance, the way it's supposed to be. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America. And to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. That is how it goes. That's how it's gone for decades. The two words under God were added a little later. They were voted in by Congress. Our leaders. Because we are a nation under God. We are indivisible. But it seems that the left and the socialists and the communists in this country want to divide us. If the words under God offend you, then don't say them. But love America. Now, if NBC running away at the mouth, running away with the editing tape, isn't bad enough, let's take a look at little Eugene Organ. Yes, that organ, you know, the state up there, up north of us a little ways. Their city council made a resolution banning the Pledge of Allegiance. They said it was divisive to force people to say under God, indivisible. Why is that? How is that divisive? Are we not one nation? Or are we a bunch of nations? No, we're a bunch of states under one nation. The United States of America, not the divided states of America. We have individual states. And up until a few years ago, we had individual state rights. But still, we're one nation. One Oregon councilman said that she feels that she can't pledge herself to just one nation. That would be bad. Because she's not a citizen of the nation. She's a citizen of the world. Huh? Well, why don't you take your citizen of the world, walk on out to, say, like, Indonesia or China or some other socialist communist country where you'll feel better about yourself and feel and know that the government is there for you. And your travel documents, since you're a citizen of the world, you should be able to get into those countries. No problem. Don't worry about a visa or anything. You're a citizen of the world. Right. Just to make, you know, matters worse and to, you know, poke every veteran who's ever served in peacetime or war in the eye, the Houston Veterans Administration has banned the words God and Jesus from their cemetery in Houston, Texas. In order to be able to say anything at the grounds, you have to submit your speech or your prayer or whatever in writing to the government, to the VA administration, for prior approval before you can say it. Sounds a lot like tyranny to me. Since when was a individual in the United States supposed to submit anything that they wish to say in writing ahead of time to the government for approval before they say it? That is a blatant, blatant attack on the First Amendment of the United States of America, the cornerstone of all of our freedoms in this nation. It's the one that gives us freedom of speech, freedom of religion, freedom of the press. It gives us the right to address our grievances to Congress or to the government. Yet this administration just sits back on its laurels and allows petty dictators such as this person in the VA administration in Texas to make those kind of announcements. Now, they have taken it to federal court, but why was it immediately ordered a halt to? The judge did say that they've stepped far too far, but yet they're maintaining that since it is government property, the utterance of God and Jesus, being that we have a separation of church and state, shall not be on this ground. I find that difficult to believe. And as a veteran, I am appalled. Absolutely appalled. I cannot believe that a government organization would step so far as to violate everyone's First Amendment rights, when it comes to free speech and freedom of religion. I took an oath to uphold and defend the Constitution of the United States of America from all enemies, foreign and domestic. This current administration, is doing their dead level best to destroy the Constitution that I supported and defended. I challenge each and every one of you out there to take the same oath I did when I entered the service. And it's simple. Just take an oath to uphold and defend the Constitution from all enemies, public or foreign and domestic. It's that simple. We're Americans. We have the right of free speech. We have the right to make idiots of ourselves. We have the right to say God wherever we choose. And if God isn't our cup of tea, we have the right to not say God. We are not a nation of cowards. We are not afraid. Yet we are being forced, little by little, inch by inch, into the same kind of tyranny that we declared ourselves independent from over 200 years ago today. Why are we sitting back and allowing that? Why aren't we on our feet screaming? Is it because we're afraid of offending one of those liberal whack jobs? Are we afraid that we'll be shouted down? It's not so much the shouting, it's just the saying of no. You have certain rights. If you do not defend those rights, they will be taken away, inch by inch by inch. And once they're gone, they're not coming back until drastic measures happen. I'd prefer not to see those drastic measures happen. I'd prefer to have our rights restored to us and be one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Happy 4th of July, ladies and gentlemen, and I will leave you with a little Lee Greenwood.
If tomorrow all the things were gone, I'd work for all my life, and I had to start again with just my children and my wife. Thank my lucky stars to be living here today, 'cause the flag still stands for freedom and they can't take that away. And I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died, who gave that right to me. And I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today, 'cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA.
I am the River. Get involved. Send your emails to therivermc@gmail.com. Also visit our blog. Details are in this post.
Mojave County. Craigslist. Rants and Raves.
Avast, ye scallywags, it's another pirate production.